incredibly complex.
2004.
No, it wasn't 04. It was 09. It was 09. So, and it, you know, it happens like every 7th, 11th, 16th, 22nd. Like, it's a very strange calendar cycle that's based on this computation that the rabbis had that I certainly don't understand, but I studied it and it just made me more confused. But what that means for us tonight is that we get to enter into Rosh Hashanah in this unprecedented time of strife on the wake of our beloved Ruth Bader Ginsburg having a final walk home. We get to defiantly step into Rosh Hashanah at this time, watching the zero that was 5780 pop away and enter into the echad of 5781. Likvod Shabbos Kodesh, with the beautiful honor of the Holy Sabbath. If there isn't a more defiant way to walk into the high holidays, I don't know. To be able to enter into Rosh Hashanah and not have it be a time of penitential prayers, not have it a time of pleading to my Father, my King, spare me, but to merely be told, life is precious. Let's live it real. And let's celebrate it while we're here. I cannot think of a more perfect and suitable turning into 5780. When we began preparing for high holidays, it was May, and there was already a lot of unrest in our country. And it was at that time I decided that tonight, when I saw it would be on Shabbos, would not be a service of a traditional Arab service. But by the time the first of Tishrei arrived, I had a hunch that we would need to clean the schmutz off. And that's why we're here. So Dennis, I apologize for the suit and tie. I should have warned you. You look beautiful. And thank you for honoring. And tonight is a night to really melt into our space, to allow the year that was to just wash away through metaphor, through imagery, through free association, through tears, through breath, through listening, to allow the turning of the year. You know, Shana has the same bilateral root as Shanui, the turning of the mind, Rosh, Shanui, Rosh Hashanah, the turning of the inner godliness in ourselves, for us to really fall into a space through sound. Finally, we're going to light these candles and start, and then I'm going to read some words of Martin Buber, a great philosopher in the 20th century. But before I do so, I want to get out the last of 5780, and I invite everyone to just say it. What do we leave and put up to the sky as sound waves for eternity and allow 5780 to release? What are we releasing?
Breathe. Loneliness.
Amen. There are bubbles in the sky.
Sadness.
Anger.
Fear.
Sadness. Fear.
Hatred.
Confusion. Hatred.
Arrogance.
Arrogance.
Cruelty.
Agitation. Stupidity.
Agitation.
Close-mindedness.
Violence.
Inequality.
Blame.
Divisiveness. Inaccuracy.
Blindness. Go away.
Chicken.
We've
been talking about something else.
She is releasing chickens.
Release the chickens. They are free now, yeah. Right? So this is a fun. And what I'm going to ask at the end for us to gather are, what are the intentions that we are gathering together as we turn from from the zero to the echad. Sonia, I'm looking at you. You want to come light?
Sure.
Beautiful. Is there anyone we're remembering in a yard site?
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Amen. She is our angel now. We get to daven to her. We are not an idolatrous people, but there is power in the crossing over. And on Yom HaDin, the day of judgment, Ruth Bader Ginsburg moved on. It was not in vain. It was, I will say, an act of righteousness in our tradition to die on Rosh Hashanah, Dafka Erev Rosh Hashanah. And so I will say, I will not be moved. She will persist through us, and she is our angel now. I don't preach, but I believe it strongly. It was not in vain. So let us rise up in defiance. I am not a political woman, but I recognize a great leader when I see one. Sorry, Tanya, I scared you away. That's okay. Yeah, you want to do it with me? Oh, sorry about that, guys. Yom HaDin, man. Whoosh.
Rabbi, if I may.
Yes, yes.
My father, blessed memory, who conducted Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur for 40 years at Rosh Hashanah Temple, died there at Rosh Hashanah.
He's got Ruach HaKodesh. He's got holiness, the Holy Spirit running through him. I embarrass him. I'm going to give us a little bit of Buber to start, and then Avi, I'll let you invite everyone into their position.
Mm-hmm.
So this is from Martin Buber. He was a 20th century philosopher. His famous work was I and Thou, a work of relational Judaism. This idea that it's in the in-between of all of us dwelling together that something is revealed. And that space in the in-between is what he termed the I and Thou. And I call that the white space, or the empty space, where godliness can happen. It's why, ideally, between each sheet we put white space. It's the idea that we were leaving white space for something to grow. Buber writes, "This is the eternal revelation, which is present in the here and now. I neither know of nor believe in any revelation that is not the same in its primal phenomenon. I do not believe in God's naming God's self or in God's defining God's self before a human. The word of revelation is, I am there as whoever I am there. That which reveals is that which reveals. That which has being is there. Nothing more. The eternal source of strength flows. The eternal touch is waiting. The eternal voice sounds. Nothing more.
Yeah, so thank you, Rabbi Lori. And yeah, I just feel like it is important to give a brief introduction to the sound, and especially in its relationship to Judaism, right? Because maybe you look at the bowls, you look at the gong, and you think of a Buddhist tradition. I believe that, you know, as a student of the Arizal and Abraham Abulafia and these different amazing Mekubalim, these Kabbalists that came before us that really paved the way for us to understand the nature of the world, they talk about how Isaac and Jacob study at the school, the Yeshiva of Shem Ve'Aver. And there, why did they travel there? Because they studied Torah from before the flood, pre-Mabu. And the Arizal talks about how they would study vibrations. And so the Arizal pretty much alludes to, and other commentators talk about, they were playing gongs way back when, before Noah. Isaac and Jacob carried on through Spain, through these different people, Abulafia.
From the Near East, which is still an Eastern tradition.
Yeah, amazing. So understanding, you know, with Rabbi Lori talking about Ruach HaKodesh, there is an element of Ruach HaKodesh and even bringing this into us bringing in the new year. Because before we prayed in a service, before we were sacrificing animals in the temple, we were tuning into the divine through sound. And so really understanding our roots, our tradition, our DNA is rooted in these vibrations. And this goes back thousands of years, tuning ourselves with sound, tuning ourselves. This is all tuned to the frequency of our bodies. And even the bowls we think relate to chakras, but they also relate to the spirit, the different ways that God has come down into this world. So that is just kind of an offering, the sound. It is all tuned to the frequency of our bodies. Our bodies take it in. It relaxes and calms down. Very good stuff. But I just kind of want to start and offer this idea of when we get to know somebody in our lives, it takes us a little while before we really let them in on our secrets and on our flaws and on our dysfunctions and on our true nature. And it sometimes takes a while. But our relationship with with our Creator, which is really what we are tuning into tonight, tomorrow, all the way through Yom Kippur and beyond, and really setting an intention for how we want this year to go. Understanding we don't need to explain anything to our Creator, right? It is feeling deeply into our relationship with our Source, with our God. And so, really tuning in over this next little bit that we are here together, aside from the beauty of this space and that we have this amazing ability to even be here, let alone be on Earth, but tuning into, what do I want from God? What does God want from me in this life? And noticing, thinking back to a year ago today, what has happened and transpired in your own life and kind of where things have gone. And I'm sure none of us had imagined 6 months ago we would be sitting on these little grass mats separated by 6 feet with masks on. And I'm sure a lot of us have felt that kind of fear, that fight or flight that Rabbi Lori was talking about. But can we also tune into the gratitude that we have for what these 6 months have brought us? Maybe an awareness of just how precious life is, or a deepening of your love for your family, a deepening of love for our health, for our breath, understanding that it can all go away in a moment's notice. And so can we really tune into that space of gratitude and set an intention of what am I really thankful for, and can I really connect with my Creator in understanding where it is all sourced? And tuning into the sound of ourselves, tuning into the sound of creation, you know, to pull a little from the East, you know, Yogi Bhajan says the gong is the quickest way to the subconscious, to the unconscious mind. And so allowing and setting an intention of what is my unconscious mind? Where have I been this last year? Have I been in fight or flight? And can I bring myself back to that rest state, that beauty, that space of gratitude? So before I start with the sound, we will do a little breathing, but you can all just kind of find a comfortable space to lay down in, laying against the ground. Noting where are my thoughts taking me right now. And also allowing any sounds that you hear above us, to the sides of us, to just bring us in even deeper into ourselves. Noting with your eyes closed, instead of looking outward, looking inward, noticing where are my thoughts in this moment, not changing them, just noticing. Am I thinking about tomorrow? Am I thinking about last year? Brushing against my skin. Am I tuning into the fragility of life? How precious our breath really, really is. And in this moment, can I even offer up thanks for it? mind starts to wander, just bringing it back to this idea of where am I? Who am I? Where do I want to go? And then as we allow ourselves to drop a little deeper into our minds, allow yourself to drop a little deeper into an awareness of your body, into this vessel that we carry out life's intentions with. Noticing if I am holding any tension in any place in my body. A little tightness in my belly. Noticing if there's maybe a lightness or heaviness in our upper chest where we experience sadness physically. Maybe when we look back at where things have been, we feel a little tinge of anger at injustice or how things could have turned out for the greater us, for our family, for me, and noticing if I'm carrying it in my jaw. If I can relax my jawline. Just through bringing an awareness to this, if we can soften the body. Even tuning into the fabric on your skin. Feeling gratitude. Notice that fabric on your skin and what it feels like on your body. Just noticing that sensation. Noticing your breath. If you're taking short, shallow breaths, or if you're breathing just a little calmer, a little slower, a little deeper. Body. And if you can imagine for this time that we have here, imagine these different parts of your body just shutting down, just switching off like a light. Feeling the body just get a little bit heavier. And a bit lighter, holding both of these at the same time. Feeling the body pressing even deeper into the ground, connecting yourself to earth. And imagining starting with the toes, just shutting down, just switching off for a moment. Letting the toes, the feet just drop to the side. And maybe it is even hard for you to even feel into your toes. And just observing that. And moving up the ankles, moving up the calves. Moving up the thighs. Taking in these legs that have carried us through this last year. And even feeling a sense of gratitude for that. For really having legs that move, that carry us. But just allowing the legs, the thighs, the ankles to just turn off and drop to the side, and moving up the waist, the hips, moving up your belly, allowing the belly to soften just by raising an awareness. Feeling the stomach soften. And moving up a little further to the chest. Feeling our heart. Noticing if there's maybe a little heaviness there. A little inward heaviness. And maybe even feeling gratitude that we can feel so deep. Just allowing that area to just switch off, to just shut down for a moment. Moving up to the shoulders, letting the shoulders drop. Just moving down the arms, the elbows, your wrists, your hands, your fingers. Even feeling into the space between your fingers. And then moving up to the throat. Have we been expressing ourselves over this last year? Have we been closing ourselves off, muting ourselves, not fully giving ourselves? And again, just noticing, observing, and allowing any tension there to just drift, just through raising an awareness of it. So allowing any stress, any tension to drift from the neck, from the throat. Feeling deeply into you even having the throat, the vocal cords, to express yourself. And then moving up the jawline and seeing if you are clenching your jaw or if you are relaxing the jaw. Feeling the face, the muscles behind your face. Muscles behind your nose, behind your eyes. Feeling into the forehead, allowing the lines in the forehead to just smooth out. Just by relaxing the face, softening the features. And to just bring us a little deeper inward. And meditating on our relationship with ourselves. Just taking a deep breath in through the mouth. Holding it there at the top. Slowly breathing it out. Allowing any sound we hear to just bring us even deeper. Taking a deep breath in through the mouth. Breathing in life. Holding it. each of these breaths, I want you to really sigh and let out any sound, anything that you have been holding on to, that has been, that you have been carrying like a weight. And letting it go and letting it not carry into this new year. So taking this deep breath in as we can, breathing in. Really letting out a sound. Knowing how that just felt, to let that out. Feeling a little lighter, taking an even deeper breath in through the mouth. How loud can you go? Letting it out. Really cleaning yourself. I'm going to do three more breaths and just lay and receive the sound, letting the mind go. Taking a deep breath in through the belly. Holding it at the top. And really letting it out. Away from you, just
bring in as we enter our bodies? What do we bring in to the 5780 Echad? What do we bring in?
Of
want us to rise for Kaddish, remembering the 200,000 counting. I want us to rise for Kaddish, remembering those who died out of injustice, those who died out of accidents, those who died because it was their time, and those who died and were surprised. We met it with surprise. This morning I went to the market like I do every Friday, and the fishmonger is no longer there. Steve died yesterday. He woke up yesterday not knowing he would die, and he will never be with us again. I say Kaddish for Steve. I stand alongside all those who mourn our friends. We say Kaddish, even though RBG is not yet buried. We will honor her memory. We will rise up in defiance, and we will remember that Kaddish is a prayer of praising God. It is not a dirge. It is not mournful. We rise up with these words, Yit Gadol V'Yit Kadosh Shemei Rabba V'Alma Divrach Yirutei V'Amlich Malchutei V'Chayechon V'Yomechon Uvchaye Dekol Beit Yisrael V'Agalav Izman Kari V'Emru Amen Yehei Shemei Rabba Mevorach Le'olam U'Lamei Almaya Yit Barach, V'Yish Tabach, V'Yit Pa'ar, V'Yit Raman, V'Yit Nasseh, V'Yit Adar, V'Yit Aleh, V'Yit Alal, Shemei Dekudashah, Brechu, Le'ela u'le'ela mikol berchata v'shirata, Tush bechata v'nechemata, V'amiram v'alma v'imru amen. Yehei Shlama Rabba min Shemaya, V'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Osei shalom v'bramam, hu ya'asei shalom, aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'al kol yoshvei tevel. Imru, amen. What do we bring into 5781? I want to hear it.
Love,
joy.
Love, joy.
Confidence.
Health.
Energy. Health.
Gratitude.
Humility.
Clarity.
Clarity.
Peace.
Happiness.
Peace. Happiness.
Grace.
Grace.
Joy.
Forgiveness.
Forgiveness. Joy.
Love.
Rain.
Rain.
Openness.
Love.
Gratitude.
Gratitude.
Democrats.
I will say, in understanding for those who are different than myself.
Humanity.
Kindness.
Kindness. Curiosity.
Life.
Life.
Freedom.
Freedom.
Appreciation.
Appreciation.
Health.
Healing.
Soul.
Babies. Yeah?
No.
Oh. It's had one. Yeah. You and Kansas, you're busy. Whoa, can't hear on time. And community. 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 Remembering. Adonai Echad. Adonai Echad. You're one. 5781. Anyone who wants a spot tomorrow, talk to Zach on the way out. I give so much love. Thank you, Avi, for such a beautiful offering. Can we give him a gratitude? It's okay to clap. Thank you, Avi. Thank you to Juan and Spencer and Zach and Jane and Jesse. And Natasha, and am I missing someone? Hannah, some other people who helped set up. Mitch, everyone, Kelly, for bringing all these offerings. Tomorrow is going to be beautiful. And the prayers we long to hear will be said. Perhaps there will be some surprises. It is Open Temple. We have all of this unexpected happening around us, this Rosh Hashanah. What a wonderful way to cultivate resilience, yes? Resilience!
Yes.
5781.
I love you. Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
Seen the dark tape.